Today, I'm going to show you how to encrypt a file with password on Windows 10 or 11. To encrypt file with password securely in Windows, the best tool is GNU Privacy Guard or GPG. This tool got a very good reputation, a long history of contribution in the software industry. It is free. You have to install it from this website. It is called GNU Privacy Guard or GNUPG. So here, after opening the website for Windows installation, you can install the GPG for Win. Keep the default setting while installing. I already have installed this tool on my computer, so now I'll directly dive into the encryption part. Here I have a PDF file, which is actually my resume. So I'll show you how to encrypt this file with a password. In order to do so, I have to open my command prompt and be on the directory where the files are present. To do this, I can click on the address bar here and type cmd and press enter. This will open the Windows command prompt on this directory. As we can see, this is the folder that this two file is present. Okay, so now I'll have to type gpg and space, then since in this encryption and decryption same passcode has to be used, this is called symmetric encryption. So I'll type hyphen hyphen symmetric, and then I'll type once again hyphen hyphen cipher hyphen algo. Means there are several encryption algorithm. This parameter will take the input which algorithm we want to use for our encryption. Here one option is AES-256, which is very popular encryption algorithm. I'm not diving into the internal implementation of this algorithm, but that is actually a very interesting thing. That is a topic for another video, I guess. So for this, the algorithm will be AES-256. Now I have to put the file name here. For the PDF, it is resume.pdf. So in GPG encryption, usually the encrypted file get a new extension called gpg. So if a file name is resume.pdf, then the encrypted file name will be resume.pdf.gpg. So as you can see in this folder, only two files is present. One is video, one is PDF. So here I have completed my command and pressing on enter. It's saying invalid option, cipher-algo. Oh, sorry, this is a typing mistake, so I have to retype the command here. This will be cipage here. So everything looks okay. I'm pressing on enter, and now a new window appeared here, as you can see. And this window is asking for a passphrase, the password we'll use to encrypt and decrypt this encrypted file. So I'm entering my passphrase or password. I'm clicking on OK, and it's saying that I have entered a insecure passphrase with my entered password. Continue with my entered key, and the encryption is complete. Resume.pdf is encrypted, and I cannot just open this file on Adobe Reader or any PDF reader without decrypting or even renaming. I have to decrypt the file with the given key to get the original file. So I think you got the idea how to encrypt the file. Okay, so let's once again encrypt the video file, which is input.mp4. See what happens. Here I'm entering another passphrase for this video file only. I'm continuing with this, and the encryption is complete. So let's create a new text file. Name is text.txt and type something. For your better understanding, let's say some dummy text, and save this file. Now let's encrypt this file. And the text file with a given text is encrypted. If I rename this file with txt for our understanding, both file is now text file. But if the first file is editable, we can see that there is a text, some dummy text, but the encrypted file, which I renamed, if I open it, I'll see that some dummy data here, means this is the encrypted data after applying the AS256 encryption algorithm. So you cannot get anything from the text. So there you have it. This is a pretty standard encryption procedure for Windows and very, very secure. Thank you so much for watching. In the next video, I'll show you some other interesting thing from GNU Privacy Guard or GPG.